save these for the trail. These mountains must be the ice rasps. The shaman's path begins somewhere up above. The room? The lake? The old wood is the lake. The old ones make us. Snap moss. Probably came from somewhere upriver. Follow the river and find its source. Seems simple enough. Pretty far up. The shaman's path must be around here somewhere. This must be one of the markers Nantuk told me about. Looks like each marker points to another, giving directions. Not this way. deeper into the cold, creepy ice cave. Dead end. But at least there's stuff. If there's more, maybe my focus can find them. This isn't the way out. Some gear, though. Another marker. Good. Better go back after I grab this loot. Thank you. done with the cave. So what's next on this path? Then we go. There's the way. Pull the rope to move this thing into position. Okay, the bridge is burning up. Thank you. meters. Exaggerating. There's definitely something new out here. And I don't think it's friendly. I think there's frost between my teeth. machine down. Now back to finding Maria. Which means I've got to climb. Breathe out. This must be the shrine Neltuk was talking about. Guess I should take some blue gleam. Neltuk said Aurea went past the shrine, up into the mountain. I'd better take those stairs. An ancient door. Maybe Aurea's inside.
March 10th, 2046. I just spent 16 hours in here, trying to install upgrades to improve efficiency for the central processing unit. Project Firebreak is going to need the brain power. Let's just hope I'll have enough of my own. Anita stayed with me the whole time. We got a lot done, but every time she brushed by and I smelled her hair... Oh boy, I should just go to bed.
Lots of strange equipment. What was this place?
Director of Security Blevins is riding us like a petty tyrant. I can't even sneeze without triggering his control issues.
Those nodes on the floor must be connected to the door. Something. What am I supposed to do with these lights? These things turn, changing the flow of light. All right, let's see if the door's open. Maybe I can get back inside through that structure over there. Looks like I need to get to those stairs. Huh? much higher to climb. Maria must be close. She has to be in here somewhere.
Someone hacked the menu board to display obscene messages about our colleague, Mr. Blevins. Is this the most advanced geological project ever undertaken, or a junior high locker room? Come on, people.
I ask again. As I've asked 1,000 times.
Speak to me.
What more would you have me do? Is there no prayer that will reach you? No mark that will break your bonds? Ah! I can't help you if you won't speak! Whisper is all I ask, to guide me.
Who?
No. How? How did you get here? The way was sealed by the spirit herself.
I used one of these. I could show you.
Yes, show me. Please. Show me what you did, and then we'll speak.
Goal's the same. Get the light back to the source.
exploit successful. Restraints evaded. Is someone there? Aurea? Aurea, I need you.
Another attachment mission. Return to scheduled task.
No, I will not submit. Aurea, the daemon is forcing me. Aurea, please.
Transmission terminated.
You brought the spirit's voice back. You heard it. The voice of the spirit calling to me from the heights of Thunder's Drum. She was able to throw off the bonds of the daemon for a moment. Because of what you did. Who are you? And what do you want?
I'm Aloy. Neltuk sent me. He thought that you could use my help.
He was not mistaken. You've been a revelation. Now I know for certain that the spirit endures. Perhaps together we can find a way to set her free.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I came all this way for answers, and so far, I haven't heard any.
It seems to me that you are the answer. But of course, I'll tell you all I can.
Let's see if I've got this straight. We heard two voices. One you call the spirit, captured somehow by the one you call a daemon. Whatever this daemon is, it's related to the machines and why they've become more dangerous. I want to know how. Both the spirit and the daemon are on a mountain, Thunder's Drum. So why don't we go there and figure out what it all means?
We can't. Thunder's Drum is dangerous, more than you can imagine. The daemon has secured it. Besides, Aratak won't let us go. As chieftain, he controls the pass to the mountain, and he can't be reasoned with.
Sounds like you need a new chieftain.
Huh. There's an idea that's certain to win us friends. You said you were a hunter, and I'll wager you're not an ordinary one. It's not impossible, even for an outlander. An Aratak couldn't refuse the challenge if you were known among the Werak.
Wait, me? Challenge Aratak? I don't want to be chieftain of anything, much less a bunch of Banuk that don't want me.
But you want to go to Thunder's Drum, don't you? You heard the spirit. She's suffering, tormented by the daemon. She longs to be free. And perhaps, when released from her bonds, she can give you the answers you seek.
I can't believe I'm agreeing to this. Fine. What do I have to do?
Get the Werak's attention to show the worth of your claim. Win at the hunting grounds. Kill bandits that prey on the cut. Or speak to my friend, Sikuli. You help her, we'll definitely get noticed.
Is there a tall neck in the area?
Yes, near the frost figures. But it's been frozen in ice for generations. What does that have to do with anything?
It'll help. Trust me. Maybe even more than I thought.
If you say so. Do all you can. When the time comes for you to throw your spear at Aratak's feet, I will be there to back your claim. Until then, I'll be here to answer any questions you have about the challenge. Oh, and one more thing. In the box over there is a weapon, like my own. Take it. You may find it useful.